Okay. The following data pertains to the healthy growth of a crop. The field capacity of a soil is 30%. Permanent wilting point is 11%. Density of a soil is 1300 kg per meter cube. Then effective depth of a root zone is 700 millimeter. Then daily consumptive use of water is 12 millimeters. And for healthy growth, the moisture content must not follow the 25% of the water holding capacity. That is between the field capacity and the permanent wilting point. And they ask determine the watering interval in a days. This example was asked in university examination for December 14, 7 marks, and also it was asked for the engineering services. Okay. Now we'll go for the given data firstly, and then we'll solve the numerical step by step. Given data over here is the field capacity they had given us as a 30%. Then wilting point, that is permanent wilting point or wilting coefficient, we can say that is 11%. It means that the between field capacity and wilting coefficient, whatever the moisture will be there, that will be the available moisture. And condition is that available moisture must not follow below the 25%. It means 75% that available moisture will be readily available to the crop. Okay. Then the gamma D they had given, that is a dry density of the soil, that is a 1300 kg per meter cube. Then gamma W, that is for the water, they had given us, from the units of the gamma D, that is kg per meter cube, we can write over here as a 1000 kg per meter cube. Then the consumptive use of a crop, that is a water required for that crop per day, is a 12 millimeter, that is a 1.2 centimeters per day water will be water requirement of that crop is there. Then a small d, that is a root zone depth they had given us, that is a 700 millimeters, that is nothing but the 70 centimeters. So this is the data again. They had given us the readily available moisture content. Now I have corrected over here, it is a readily available moisture content is a 75% of available moisture. Now you will have the question in your mind that where they had mentioned the 75%, they had mentioned a 25%, but that 25% is nothing but the lower limit of available moisture, isn't it? So for it means that above that, whatever the moisture content is there, out of that available moisture is readily available. It means remaining is 75%. It means the moisture content must not fall below the 25% of the water holding capacity, isn't it? It means that whatever the total will be there, I will go with the some of the sketches so that you will get an idea. Just a minute, I will go for the board so that you will get the idea. Now, just see over here, we'll consider this is the field capacity limit we'll consider, and then the lower limit we'll consider at as is nothing but the wilting coefficient, isn't it? So wilting coefficient is nothing but the lower limit. Just a minute, I will go for the marking also. That is, this is nothing but the field capacity and this is nothing but the wilting coefficient, isn't it? And whatever the moisture content is there existing in between those two, with those two, that is field capacity and wilting wilting coefficient, is nothing but the available moisture. So I would like to write over here is as a available moisture. Okay. Now what they had told us, they had told us that this moisture content must not fall below the 25%. यानी कि मान लो कि ये अभी आपका 100 units है, तो उसमें से 25% से कम नहीं होना चाहिए, कि यहाँ पे ये जीरो रहेगा, क्योंकि ये यहाँ पे कितना है हमारा, just I would like to write over here as a zero. Time being, I'm considering here as a zero. That is a lowest one we are considering, and here as a highest one. So I would like to write here as a 100. Time being, I'm writing here for understanding purpose only. This is zero and this is 100. So what they have told? They told that this moisture content, available moisture, must not follow below the 25%. यानी कि कहाँ पे रहेगा? यहाँ पे कहीं पे. तो I would like to go for a line over there in with a different color. I would like to go for this one. Okay. So this is nothing but the limit, we can say. So this is nothing but the 25%. So we'll go for, I would like to write over here as a 25. isn't it? So this 25 is from where? 0 to 25. It means the remaining is nothing but the 75, isn't it? And this is nothing but the readily available moisture. Which one readily available? In between those two. So I would like to go for, by a arrow we'll go for. So this is nothing but the readily available moisture between 100 to 25, isn't it? So likewise, we have to go for that solving the numerical. So it means we were herein. So the readily available moisture is now 75% of a available moisture, okay? Now, the next parameter, that is to calculate. What they have asked to calculate now? Watering interval, that is a frequency of irrigation, means after how many days now you will go for irrigation. That is, you will provide the water for that field so that there will not be any sort of the wilting of the crop. Isn't it? Any sort of wilting means that will not be permanent, temporary wilting or any type of the wilting we can say. यानी कि जो पौधा लगाया है वहाँ पे, जो भी crop लिया है, वो उसका जो proper growth हो रहा है, वो growth कभी भी यानी कि stop नहीं होगा. Okay? तो पौधा जो है वहाँ पे मुरझाएगा नहीं. अपने भाषा में तो सुकणार नहीं है, अशी condition पाहिजे आहे. म्हणजे तेवपर्यंत आपण काय करणार आहे, त्याला irrigation करणार आहे. That is asked in a days they have asked. Now we are knowing the things. We know the frequency of irrigation, that is a relation, that is a FI, the frequency of irrigation is equals to depth of water available divided by consumptive use. Yani ki jo bhi aapka readily available moisture ka jo magnitude rahega wahan pe, okay, with respect to that, that DW, depth of the water available divided by consumptive use. Yani ki aapka per irrigation by considering readily available moisture, jitna depth water ka available rahega wahan pe, उसको यदि आप उसका कंजम्पटिव यूज से डिवाइड करते हैं, यानी कि कंजम्पटिव यूज यानी कि क्या रहेगा आपका डेली वाटर रिक्वायरमेंट क्रॉप का, यानी कि क्रॉप को डेली कितना चाहिए और आपके पास कितना अवेलेबल होता है इरिगेशन करने के बाद. आपके पास इरिगेशन करने के बाद मान लो कि 100 यूनिट्स है और क्रॉप को लगता है 10 यूनिट्स पर डे, यानी कि 10 डेज तक आपको इरिगेशन करने की जरूरत नहीं है, लेकिन 10 डेज के बाद आपको इरिगेशन करना पड़ेगा, यानी कि आफ्टर 10 days will be required to go for irrigation. That is the idea. That is the frequency of irrigation is equals to DW by SCU. Now it will be required to calculate the DW with respect to the readily available moisture content. Okay. So now we are knowing that for DW, that is a depth of water we can say, we need to calculate the optimum moisture content. That is the MO we can say, which is nothing but the field capacity minus the readily available moisture. Means this MO is nothing but the lower limit of the field capacity above which the whatever the moisture is to be exist that will be easily absorbed by the root zones of a crop, isn't it? So it means for finding the optimum moisture content, will be required to find out firstly the readily available moisture over here, isn't it? So now for readily available moisture, we are knowing that the readily available moisture to the crop as per the given data is a 75% of available moisture, isn't it? So firstly, we will be required to calculate that available moisture. So now available moisture is nothing but in between field capacity and a wilting coefficient that we have on a board itself. Okay. So now firstly, we'll go for that part. That is now available moisture to the crop is the field capacity minus wilting coefficient. So field capacity is given as a 30%, means a 0.3. minus that a wilting coefficient is 11%. It is a 0.11. It means that its magnitude comes to be 0.19, isn't it? So available moisture is from the field capacity and wilting coefficient is a 19% or a 0.19 units we can say. Now this is available moisture. Out of that, the whatever the readily available moisture is there, its magnitude is a 75%, because the condition is given that this available moisture jo bhi humne abhi yahan pe nikala hai uska jo magnitude hai wo 25% se kam nahi hona chahiye, yani ki 25% se kam nahi hona chahiye, yani ki kitna available hona chahiye, 75% wo available hai, readily available hai. So we'll go for that now. That is a, therefore readily available moisture is equals to 0.75 into available moisture. 75% ka maine 0.75 liya aur 19% ka maine 0.19 liya. Okay, so uska magnitude aata hai 0.75 into 0.19. If you do that calculation, then you will get the value as a 0.1425 or we can say here as a 14.25% also, isn't it? And ki readily available moisture kitna hai hamare paas abhi 0.1425 utna hai. Okay, wo kyun chahiye hame? Because we want to calculate that magnitude for the finding for finding the magnitude of an optimum moisture content, isn't it? So 0.1425 we got now. Now after that, using this magnitude, we will calculate the MO, that is optimum moisture content. So we are knowing that optimum moisture content is equals to field capacity minus readily available moisture. Field capacity is a 30%, that is a 0.3 minus this readily available moisture is a 0.1425. So its magnitude comes to be 0.1575 to get. It means a 15% is a limit of a optimum moisture content for this particular case. Okay, now we'll calculate the DW firstly. There is a depth of the water by considering that optimum moisture content. We are knowing that for this relationship is DW is equals to gamma D by gamma W into root zone depth into field capacity minus optimum moisture content. Just to put the values, that is the gamma D is a 1300 kg per meter cube they had given. Then gamma W as a 1000 into root zone depth as a 700 millimeters, so 70 centimeters. Isn't it? Then into field capacity 0.30 minus optimum moisture content as a 0.1575. So we used to get the magnitude for DW as a 12.97 centimeter. Sorry, by mistake I had an here meter. This is a centimeters. Okay. So this is 12.97 centimeters. I will correct it. Just a minute. 12.97. Unit will be a centimeters. Why centimeters? Because we have considered the root zone depth in a centimeters, 70 centimeters. Then this 13 kg per meter cube, this 1000 kg per meter cube, they will cancel to each other, and this is in a percentage. So unit of a depth, root zone depth, will be carried over there in. This is a 12.97 centimeters. We can say over here in. Then this is a DW. Now we have to calculate the frequency of irrigation, that is the days after irrigation will be carried out to, and it is given as Fi is equals to DW by Cu. Now depth of the water available by considering optimum moisture content and the root zone depth is nothing but the 12.97 and the consumptive use is 1.2 centimeters. Okay, so 12.97 by 1.2, its magnitude comes to be 10.81. And it will be in a days. Why? Because this consumptive use is a per day, isn't it? So this magnitude will be days. It means after 10.81 days we will be required to go for irrigation. But we must not consider that 10.8 exactly, or we must not consider the 11. If you consider the 11, it means that whatever the 0.19 days, that gap will be there in. Means if you consider the hours, then a 24 hours into 0.19, it will give us an that much delay of the hours for the irrigation. So to avoid that, we are going to start the irrigation after a 10 days only. Means suppose that we had an irrigation now on a today, that is on a 23, we can say, then after a 10 days, after a 10 days interval, we will go for the next irrigation. Okay, so frequency of irrigation will be up to 10 days for this particular condition. Okay, the base period, intensity of irrigation and duty of various crops under a canal irrigation system are given below. Find the reservoir capacity if the canal losses are 20% and the reservoir losses are 12%. It was asked three times it was asked for the university examination. Okay, they had given us the data. That is the crops. They had given us the crops as a wheat, sugarcane, cotton, rice, and vegetables. Then base periods of the crops as a 120 for a wheat, sugarcane 360 days, cotton 200, rice 120, vegetables 120. Okay. Then a duty at the field, that is in hectares per cumac, that is a 1800 for the wheat, 800 for a sugar cane, cotton it's a 1400, rice it's a 900, vegetables it's a 700, and then area under the crop in hectares for a wheat it is a 4800, for sugar cane 5600, cotton it's a 2400, rice it's a 3200, vegetables it's a 1400. This data is given to us, and they had given us that to find the reservoir capacity. यानी कि जो भी रिजर्वायर हम कंस्ट्रक्ट करेंगे उसमें पानी कितना आपको होना चाहिए ताकि आप ये जो क्रॉप्स है उसको आप पानी दे सकेंगे, इरिगेशन कर पाएंगे. कब? जब कैनाल लॉसेस जो है, यानी कि जब आप कैनाल ऑप्टेक करेंगे, यानी कि जो कैनाल आपका रिजर्वायर से स्टार्ट होगा और आपके फील्ड तक आएगा, तब तक जो पानी कन्वे करेगा उसमें से 20% लॉस होगा. यानी कि 100 liters आपने पानी वहां से रिलीज किया from the head of the canal, then at the tail of the canal you will get 80 liters of the water, because 20% loss is there, isn't it? And reservoir losses are 12%. यानी कि reservoir में यदि आपने 100 liters store किया है तो उसमें से 12% loss होने वाला है, यानी कि 88 liters खाली आपके पास बचेगा वहां पे reservoir में. Okay, so reservoir में पानी कब आएगा आपके? At the during the monsoon or at the end of the monsoon season, we can say. So during that days only we have to store the water. यानी कि तब यदि आपको पानी रिजर्वायर में स्टोर करना है तो आप कितना करोगे ताकि ये जो क्रॉप्स दिए है, उनकी ड्यूटीज दिए है, उनका बेस पीरियड और एरिया अंडर देम दिया है, उसको आप इरिगेशन कर पाएंगे. ओके, सो यानी कि यहाँ पे हमें पहले क्या करना पड़ेगा? फर्स्टली विल बी रिक्वायर्ड टू कैलकुलेट द वाटर रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी क्रॉप, इजंट इट? देन अ सीजन वाइज और द कॉम्बिनेशन वाइज एंड द मैक्सिमम combination amount which we are getting, that we will be required to calculate. यदि हमें यहाँ पे पूरा के पूरे crops simultaneously ले लिए तो total requirement कितना आता है crop का, सभी crops का मिला के वो requirement लेके, यानी कि मान लो कि आपको irrigation जो करना है, अभी यहाँ पे अपने cotton वगैरह लिया तो वो generally क्या है, खरीफ crop है, so खरीफ में ही सब आएगा. So wheat आएगा रबी में, लेकिन छोड़ दो रबी का कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, लेकिन कॉटन, राइस, वेजिटेबल्स, शुगर केन हमने लिया तो वो पेरिनियल क्रॉप्स हैं. यानी कि सब क्रॉप्स को मिला के एक सीजन में पर सीजन कितना पानी लगता है वो आपको निकालना पड़ेगा, और उसके बाद जो भी लॉसेस दिए हुए है वो लॉसेस हमें कॉम्पेसेट करने पड़ेगा. ओके, सो हाउ टू गो फॉर दो टू मेथड्स आर देयर इन आउट ऑफ दैट वन ऑफ द मेथड दैट इज फाइंडिंग द डेल्टा. फर्स्टली दैट इज total depth of the water required for that particular crop during its base period we are calculating, and once you will get the delta, then we are going to multiply that delta by a area so that you will get the volume requirement. So here delta you will get, that is a depth of the water required for that crop during the base period. So how to get it? By the relation of a duty and a delta, that is a delta is equals to 8.64 into base period upon a duty. Okay, so duties are given to us and deltas are also given to us. So what we did here, we have prepared the two tables, a table herein, and here I had given the numberings also for each and every column, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So first one is a crop as it is given, second one is the base period as it is given, duty at the field in hectare cubic, that is column number 3, which is also given to us. The next column which added herein, that is the delta requirement, it means the depth of water required for the crop during its entire base period. So how we have calculated here? We have calculated by using the standard relationship between the duty and the delta, that is a delta is equals to 8.64 into B upon D is therein, isn't it? So for the first crop, that is a wheat, if you go for calculation, that is 8.64 into base period as a 120 upon 1800, then we used to get the magnitude as a 0.57. Isn't it? So likewise, we have calculated the delta for each and every crop over herein. So we got for a sugarcane as a 3.88, for the cotton as a 1.23, then for a rice it's a 1.15, then a vegetables it's a 1.48. Those are the depth of the water required for the each and every crop during their entire base period. Okay, so this is the magnitude of the delta which you have calculated. Then the next one, that is finding the volume. So how to find out the volume? So for finding the volume, as we are knowing that volume is nothing but the area into depth. So area is nothing but the surface area over which the crop has been cultivated or crop has been grown, we can say. So that area for each and every crop is given to us. That is a, for a wheat, it's a 4800 means 4,800 hectares is there. So if you multiply that 4,800 hectares by that delta, that is a depth we can say of requirement, it is 0.57, then you will get the volume of the water required to irrigate that wheat. So it comes to be 2736. So volume delta into area, it is in hectare meters. So column number 6 will be the multiplication of the column number 4, that is a delta, and the column number 5, that is the area in a hectares. So likewise, we have calculated for each and every crop is a, as a volume, and then we have taken the summation also. And that summation we found that is a 33,168 hectare meters is the total volume of water required for the all the crops when we are going to irrigate them. Okay, when we want to irrigate them, isn't it? Now, this is the water requirement at the field, because the duties are given at the field. Those the that duty at the field is given. So from that we got the magnitude for the total water requirement at the field itself. Now at the reservoir we want to calculate. ये जो हमें लगने वाला volume है 33,168 वो अभी कहाँ पे है? This is there at the field only. Now हमें जो हम construct करने वाले हैं reservoir, उसमें कितना पानी हमें स्टोर करना पड़ेगा ताकि जो भी 12% कैनाल लॉस है और 20% कैनाल लॉस है और 12% हमारा रिजर्वायर लॉस है वो कॉम्पेंसेट करके हमें नेट वॉल्यूम 33,168 उतना फील्ड पे मिलेगा. दैट वी वांटेड टू कैलकुलेट. नाउ हाउ टू गो फॉर दैट? सो हियर नाउ कंसीडर द कैनाल लॉसेस एंड द रिजर्वायर लॉसेस टू गेट द रिक्वायर्ड कैपेसिटी, दैट इज द वॉल्यूम ऑफ अ रिजर्वायर. सो हियर फर्स्टली आई वुड लाइक टू गो फॉर अ शो यू दैट इज हाउ इट इज टू बी देयर इन. So now suppose that a reservoir I would like to go for an arbitrary shape I would like to go for. Suppose that this is an our reservoir we will consider over here in, and we'll consider that this is a barrier. Just a minute. This is a barrier we will consider over here. That is a dam we used to talk about. Let's consider this as a barrier that is a dam, and on its upstream side whatever the volume of the water is stored that we are considering as a reservoir. So this is nothing our a reservoir R I would like to write over here in, and this is nothing but the our dam I would like to write as a D. Okay, now from this reservoir we are going to optake the canals. Or what we are going to do, we are going to take the canal. Suppose that this is a canal which we are taking from the reservoir. Timing I am considering. Likewise, this is a canal. Okay, so this is a canal we are considering herein. Okay, so I would like to write over here as a C as a canal, and here somewhere else we will have the our field. So I will make a plot here as a field now. This is a field where we have grown the various crops. Okay, suppose that this is a one plot, this is a another plot, and this is a third one, and likewise we have cultivated all the crops in this particular field. Now at this field I would like to write as a field as F over herein. So at the field we have calculated the amount required as a Q. हमने जो volume अभी भी निकाला है वो क्यू जो हमें लगने वाला है वो हमने कहाँ पे निकाला है? We have calculated that volume at a field. Okay. लेकिन अभी उन्होंने क्या दिया है, जो भी कैनाल यहाँ से पानी डाइवर्ट करेगा यानी कि क्यू जो देगा यहाँ पे वहां से सब लॉस यहाँ पे हो रहा है, सम लॉस हो रहा है. सो आई वुड लाइक टू राइट हियर एज अ सी एल. सी एल मीन्स कैनाल लॉस, एंड कैपिटल आर सफिक्स एल मीन्स नथिंग बट द रिजर्वायर लॉस. तो हमें निकालना क्या है, जो रिजर्वायर का जो कैपेसिटी है जो कि हमें क्यू अमाउंट यहाँ पे देगा वो कैपेसिटी हमें निकालना है. तो पहले हमें क्या करना पड़ेगा, जो भी हमें यहाँ पे क्यू अमाउंट वाटर लगने वाला है, जो हम कहाँ से लेने वाले हैं, कैनाल से लेने वाले. फील्ड में कहाँ से पानी आएगा, यहाँ से आएगा, कैनाल से आएगा. और कैनाल कहाँ से पानी लेगा, रिजर्वायर से लेगा. लेकिन जो भी अमाउंट कैनाल रिजर्वायर से लेगा, यहाँ से पानी उसमें लेगा, तब वो पानी यहाँ से डाइवर्ट करते वक्त यानी कि यहाँ से ऑप्टेक करेगा वो और यहाँ पे पानी दे देगा, तब तक क्या होता है सम अमाउंट सीएल उतना अमाउंट लॉस होता है। वो कितना दिया है हमने, हमें उन्होंने 20% लॉस उन्होंने दिया है। सो दिस इज नथिंग बट द 20% लॉस इज गोइंग टू ऑकर। यानी कि यहां से हमने यदि 100 यूनिट्स वाटर ले लिया तो उसमें 20% लॉस होगा और हमें यहाँ पे कितना मिलेगा, हमें यहाँ पे मिलने वाला है 80%, 80 मिलने वाला है। 100 में से 20% गया, सो कितना मिलेगा हमें यहाँ पे, खाली 80 मिलेगा। अभी हमें लगने वाला है कितना यहाँ पे, हमें यहाँ पे लगने वाला वॉल्यूम है क्यू। सो हमें क्या करना पड़ेगा, पहले इस क्यू में 20% ऐड करना पड़ेगा। यानी कि इफ वी वांट टू मूव टुवर्ड्स द रिजर्वायर इन दिस डायरेक्शन देन वी विल बी रिक्वायर्ड टू ऐड द वाटर एज क्यू प्लस 20% कैनाल लॉसेस। यानी कि फर्स्टली हमें क्या करना पड़ेगा, वी विल बी रिक्वायर्ड टू ऐड द 20% कैनाल लॉसेस इनटू द रिक्वायर्ड अमाउंट ऑफ द क्यू व्हिच इज एट द फील्ड, ताकि हमें यहां से हम जो वॉल्यूम रिलीज करेंगे वो वॉल्यूम हमारा कितना रहेगा अभी, दैट क्यू प्लस 20% कैनाल लॉसेस। तो हम कहां पे आ गए, हम यहाँ पे आ गए, यानी कि रिजर्वायर से जहां पे कैनाल ऑप्टेक करता है वहां पे हमें जो मिलने वाला वॉल्यूम है वो करेक्टेड मिलेगा। लेकिन उन्होंने बाद में क्या किया है, अभी अभी मान लो कि हमें यहां से क्यू वन इतना अमाउंट मिल गया, ये कितना मिल गया हमें अभी, क्यू वन उतना वॉल्यूम मिल गया है करेक्शन करने के बाद। कौन सा करेक्शन, कैनाल लॉस का। लेकिन अभी उन्होंने क्या किया है, जो भी अमाउंट आप यहाँ पे स्टोर करते हैं उसमें से 12% लॉस हो जाता है रिजर्वायर से, जो इवेपोरेशन रहेगा, डीप परकुलेशन रहेगा और भी कुछ जो है, जो चीजें हैं उनमें, उनसे क्या होगा, 12% वाटर जो है वो यहाँ से रिजर्वायर लॉस के तरह वजह से लॉस हो जाएगा, isn't it? यानी कि उसका मतलब क्या हो गया, जो भी आपको अभी Q1 अमाउंट लगने वाला है कहाँ पे, यहाँ पे लगने वाला है, वो आप कहाँ से लेने वाले हैं, वो आप यहाँ से लेने वाले हैं। तो यदि आप ये पानी यहाँ से लेना चाहते हैं तो क्या करना पड़ेगा आपको, जो Q1 अमाउंट आपको यहाँ पे लगने वाला है उसमें आपको 12% एडिशनल वाटर यहाँ पे स्टोर करना पड़ेगा, ताकि ये जो पहले क्या होगा 12% लॉस हुआ इवापोरेशन से, तो क्या मिलेगा आपको, Q1 मिलेगा। Q1 से 20% लॉस होगा तो क्या मिलेगा आपको, अल्टीमेटली Q मिलेगा। यानी कि एट दिस पॉइंट आई वुड लाइक टू चेंज द कलर ओवर हियर इन, एट दिस पॉइंट वी विल बी रिक्वायर्ड टू हैव द अमाउंट ऑफ द वाटर इन द रिजर्वायर एज Q1 प्लस दिस 12% रिजर्वायर लॉसेस, 12% रिजर्वायर लॉसेस, दैट इज RL वी हैव मेंशनड ओवर हियर इन, isn't it? So likewise, we will have combination. यानी कि this is nothing but the required storage at a reservoir. उतना volume हमें reservoir में store करना पड़ेगा। अभी हम यदि downward movement करेंगे, यानी कि reservoir में कितना है हमें store किया? Q1 plus 20% उसका जो losses है, वो है, मान लो ये सब मिला के जो मिलता है volume हमें, वो हमें Q2 उतना मिलता है। ये कितना मिल गया हमें? Q2 इतना वॉल्यूम मिल गया। Q2 यानी कि कितना है? Q1 plus 12% रिजर्वायर लॉसेस है। अभी रिजर्वायर में Q2 हमने स्टोर कर दिया, लेकिन वो क्या होगा? स्टोर करने के बाद 12% लॉस हो गया। सो लॉस होने के बाद हमें कितना मिलेगा? Q1 मिलेगा। यानी कि 12% गया इसमें से Q2 से, तो कितना मिलेगा हमें? Q1 मिलेगा। लेकिन Q1 अमाउंट हमें कहां पे मिला? यहां पे रिजर्वायर से हम जो यहां पे पानी ले रहे हैं वहां पे हमें वो मिल गया। बाद में रिजर्वायर से जब हम उसको पानी को ले लेते हैं, कहां से? रिजर्वायर में से, कैनाल से पानी हम खेत तक ले लेते हैं, तो क्या होगा? 20% लॉस होगा। यानी क्या होगा? Q1 माइनस 20% होगा, तो हमें कितना मिलेगा? डायरेक्टली Q, दैट इज द रिक्वायर्ड अमाउंट एट द फील्ड वी विल गेट। सो लाइकवाइज वी हैव टू सॉल्व द न्यूमेरिकल। ओके, सो इट मीन्स वट एवर द सोल्यूशन वी हैड ओवर हियर इन, हियर फर्स्टली वी विल बी रिक्वायर्ड टू गो फॉर द 30% ओनली, okay, so sorry 20% of a canal losses, and then afterwards we'll be required to add that reservoir losses in the whatever the amount we got. It means here first we will be required to add the canal losses so that we will get the water at the head of the canal. So this is required volume at head of a canal, जो हमने Q1 बोला था, that Q1 is nothing but the 4378 0.76 hectometer. Now at reservoir, or in the reservoir we can say, sorry, now not at, but in the reservoir we can say, now in the reservoir, sorry, I would like to again, I would like to simplify it. Reserve or required, okay, so required volume in the reservoir, it is a storage we can say. So this will be now is equals to 43781.76 plus that reservoir losses will be there in, isn't it? Reservoir losses kitna hai? 12% hai. Abhi 12% kiska rahega? 12% of this much, yani ki इसमें से 12% ऐड करके हम हमें वहां पे रहना चाहिए. ओके, दैट विल बी इक्वल्स टू 43781.76 प्लस 12% की आई वुड लाइक टू राइट डायरेक्टली 0.12 इनटू 43781.76. ओके, now just calculate the value now. So it comes to be 43781.76 plus 0.12 into 43781.76. it's a 43705.37. This will be, unit will be hectare meters. That much volume will be required in the reservoir. This will be the reservoir storage capacity, we can say. Okay, so here the value which you will get by considering canal losses is about 39801.6. Okay, now this is required volume at the head of the canal. Now required volume at the reservoir will be considering reservoir losses, यानी कि इसमें हमें 12% add करना पड़ेगा. Okay, so this one plus the reservoir losses. So this will be just a minute. And it this magnitude comes to be 445. Just a minute, I would like to write over here in. This is a 44577.79 hectare meters. Okay. So this is a exact amount of water which is required in the reservoir as a storage. So that whatever the amount which we are requiring at the field, that is a 33168, will be get fulfilled. Okay. Okay. So on the similar lines, we have this next example: the base period intensity of irrigation and the duty of various crops under a canal irrigation system are given below. Find the reservoir capacity if the canal losses are 25% and the reservoir losses are at 20%. So data is changed over here. That is a 25% and 20%. Wheat, sugarcane, cotton, rice, and vegetables. Base periods are given to us. Duty at the field in hectare cubic, that is also given to us. And area under the crop in hectares, this is also given to us. Now we'll go for directly the part of the solution, that is a finding the volume by considering the delta for each and every crop, and then a required volume at the reservoir, that is a reservoir capacity. Okay, so duty, delta, and all those things we have calculated over here. Delta, duty already they had given us. The duty we have, sorry, duty they had given us, and delta we have to calculate over here. In so here, as like in a previous example, we have calculated the deltas by using the equation, that is the delta is equals to 8.64 into B by D. D is nothing but the duty. So for by calculating the duty, we have calculated the volume also. That is, the volume is equals to area into the depth, that is a delta, we can say. So we got the volume for each and every crop, and net volume required for all the crops to be get irrigated from the canal is about 44,315 hectares meter. This is the volume of water required at the field. Okay, because the duties are given at the field. So now from this, we have to calculate the volume of water required at the reservoir. Okay, so now we'll go for that. It means first you will be required to add the canal losses, and then will be required to add the reservoir losses. So canal losses are 20% and reservoir losses are 25%. So here volume plus canal losses plus the reservoir losses. It means your canal losses will be like this. The equation will be like this, into summation volume into canal losses. And lastly, the whatever this net sum will get plus that reservoir losses we have to go for. Okay. Now this comes to be, if we'll deduct this one, which we had and calculated as previously, we will get over here in, that is a 44,315 plus 44,315 into 25% means 0.25. It comes to be 5,240 hectares meter instead of 64,256. Okay, this is the volume required at the head of the canal. This is where it is required. This volume, or this much volume, is required at head of a canal. Okay, now volume required at a reservoir, that is a reservoir capacity, we can say, and it is equals to this volume plus the reservoir losses, or reservoir loss we can say, that is equals to 5,401.25 hectare meters plus it's given as a 20%. So it means 0.20 into this required volume at the head of the canal plus 0.20 into 5,401.25, and it comes to be 66,481. That's equals to 66,481.5 hectares meter. Okay, this much volume will be required to have in the reservoir, that is nothing as a reservoir capacity, we can say. Okay, just check the answer, is it correct? I hope so. This answer is correct.